Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is chromatography. It is an important technique in biochemistry. It can be asked as a short note in university examination for MBBS students. And for paramedical students, it can be asked as a LAQ, long answer question. Okay, we will discuss this topic under the heading of definition, classification and application. What is the literal meaning of chromatography? Chroma means color and graphy means writing. It is a color writing. This technique was introduced by Michael Sweet on a separation of plant pigment, chlorophyll. That's why the name is given, chromatography. Chroma means color and graphy means writing. There are two important terminologies here in this technique, mobile phase and stationary phase. So, mobile phase and stationary phase. Take one example of paper chromatography. Here, this Wattmann filter paper, it is used as a inert media. This is a solvent system which contains bad solvent, that is butanol, acetic acid and distilled water in a ratio of 4:1:5. This is for separation of amino acids. These are the amino acid spots. This is, suppose this is phenylalanine, this is histidine and this is a mixture of both. In this solvent system, this butanol will move over by a capillary action through this filter paper. And the substance which has more solubility toward a solvent system, it will move upward. And the which has less solubility, it will move less as compared to this first one. Okay, so this is mixture, this is a spot of histidine, this is a spot of phenylalanine. And by calculating RF value, you can identify the specific spots. So this is a solvent system. Now what is mobile phase here? Which phase is moving? This solvent system is moving. So butanol or solvent system is a state mobile phase here. Butanol or a solvent system is a mobile phase here. And what is stationary phase then? Wattmann paper is not a stationary phase here. It acts as a inert media. Support media or inert media. On this support media, water get adsorbed. So water is a stationary phase. Water adsorbed on paper is a stationary phase here. It is an important point. Water adsorbed on cellulose of filter paper by a weak interaction, mainly by the hydrogen bonds or van der Waals forces, act as a stationary phase in paper chromatography. So here stationary phase is a liquid and mobile phase is also a liquid. So this is a liquid chromatography. Liquid chromatography. Got it? Difference between mobile phase and stationary phase. It is clear now. Take another example. This is a column packed with alumina. This is a solvent system here. This is a adsorbent material. Okay. Now here stationary phase is alumina. It is a adsorbent material, alumina, and mobile phase is a solvent system. This solvent will move in downward direction through this alumina. And the solute, the sample gets separated on the basis of their affinity with the alumina and their solubility with the solvent system. Got it? The compound which are more soluble in the solvent system will elute out first, and the compound which has less solubility will elute out last. Got it? So here stationary phase is alumina, which is a solid, and mobile phase is a liquid. So this is a liquid solid chromatography. this paper chromatography is a liquid liquid chromatography. Column chromatography with alumina as a adsorbent material is a liquid solid chromatography. Now, what is the definition of chromatography? It is a technique or it is a procedure for a separation of a similar compound. Write down definition. It is a technique or procedure for a separation of similar compounds. Similar compounds by its continuous redistribution. Continuous redistribution between two phases. Two phases, that is stationary phase and mobile phase. Compound which has retention power, which has retention power and less solubility, means it depends upon affinity and solubility of compounds towards stationary and mobile phase. If it is less soluble in mobile phase and if it has more affinity towards the stationary phase, it will remain. It will remain or it will retain on the stationary phase. If it has less retention power or less affinity towards the stationary phase and more solubility in a mobile phase, it will move in upward direction as compared to others. This is a basic principle involved in a chromatography. And depending upon this stationary phase and mobile phase, there are various types of chromatography. Now we'll see the classification and types of chromatography. On the basis of this is chromatography. On the basis of mobile phase, it is divided into mobile phase. It is divided into two main types. Mobile phase can be liquid or it can be gas. Solid cannot be a mobile phase. Okay, it can be a liquid which moves over or a gas. If it is gas, it is known as gas chromatography. If it is liquid, it is known as liquid chromatography. Very, very simple. For example, HPLC, high pressure or high performance liquid chromatography. It is a type of liquid chromatography depending upon mobile phase. Now, depending upon stationary phase, then stationary phase can be solid or it can be liquid. Here also, it can be solid, it can be liquid. And depending on this, there are two more types of liquid chromatography, that is liquid solid chromatography and liquid liquid chromatography. In gas chromatography, two types, gas solid chromatography and gas liquid chromatography. Got it? These are the types of gas chromatography, that is gas solid and gas liquid chromatography. And here liquid solid chromatography, liquid liquid chromatography. Now take one example. Liquid solid chromatography. If a column made up of alumina or kieselguhr, in kieselguhr or alumina, the adsorbent material is kieselguhr or alumina. In this type of chromatography, column chromatography, this will follow this principle, means liquid solid chromatography. Here, alumina example is column chromatography. Column with alumina as a adsorbent material. Here alumina act as a solid stationary phase. Solvent system will be the mobile or liquid mobile phase. Got it? Then second, liquid liquid chromatography example is paper chromatography. Liquid liquid, where stationary phase is liquid and the mobile phase is also liquid. It is paper chromatography. Then gas chromatography, here when the adsorbent material is alumina-like, it is known as gas solid chromatography. And here when it is adsorbent material is different, for example silica gel, it will adsorb some water on it, so it will become gas liquid chromatography. Okay, where liquid act as a stationary phase, means water held on inert support medium act as a stationary phase. Here also water adsorb on a inert paper, Wattmann filter paper, act as a stationary phase. So these are the main types of chromatography. Now these types of chromatography will follow five basic principles. These are the first one is adsorption. First principle is adsorption, which is a surface phenomenon. Then second one is the partition. Third one is molecular sieving. Fourth one is a ion exchange. And fifth one is a affinity. These are also known as types of chromatography: adsorption chromatography, partition chromatography, molecular sieving effect, ion exchange, or affinity chromatography. They are the mechanism or physicochemical reactions involved in a separation of compound in a chromatography. Adsorption, it is a surface phenomenon in which one molecule adsorb on a other, and depending upon the adsorption power, separation happens. Okay, for example, alumina here act as an adsorbent material, and if the compound has more affinity towards this alumina, it will retain in the alumina, while another which has less affinity will move in a downward direction and will elute out through this. Got it? This is known as adsorption chromatography, mainly the solid liquid chromatography, where stationary phase is a solid, for example alumina, kieselguhr. When these type of materials are used, it is known as adsorption chromatography. Then partition, it depends on the solubility towards mobile phase. If compound is more soluble in a mobile phase, it will move out earlier. It will move fast. If it is less soluble, it will retain. It will movement will be slow. That is known as partition. There is competition in a mobile phase. Okay, so it is known as partition chromatography. The liquid chromatography, the paper chromatography is the example of partition chromatography. Thin layer chromatography is an example of partition chromatography. If in thin layer the adsorbent material is silica gel, it adsorbs some water with it, it is an example of partition chromatography. HPLC, it is an example of partition chromatography. Okay, if you use a material which adsorb water and this liquid phase act as a stationary phase, then it is known as partition chromatography. If it does not adsorb water on it, if alumina, kieselguhr, they are used there, it is known as adsorption chromatography. Got it? So paper chromatography, HPLC, TLC, these are the example of partition chromatography. If in column we use silica gel, if on the plate we use silica gel adsorbs some water, and this water act as a stationary phase, then it is known as partition chromatography. Now what is meaning of molecular sieving? In this molecular sieving, the columns, they are packed with gel type material. Different types of gel, and the separation, it has beads in it. This gel has beads in it, and these beads has pores. In this, these beads has pores. So smaller particles get entrapped inside these beads and will move slow. and larger particles will elute out fast in this type of chromatography. This is known as molecular sieving effect. The smaller particles get entrapped inside the beads in a gel due to the molecular sieving effect. It is dependent on size of a particle, mainly size and shape of a particle. The larger particles will elute out fast and smaller particle will retain in a beads. This is known as molecular sieving effect. It is also known as gel filtration chromatography. Gel filtration chromatography. In ion exchange, there are two types, cation exchange resin and anion exchange resin. Two types of resins are there. The column, it is packed with a resins, and exchange of material occur in between these resins and compounds on the basis of their charge. So it is dependent on ionization. Cation exchange resin will exchange cations, and the anion exchange resin will exchange anions. Cation exchange resin will retain positively charged ion, and anion exchange resin will retain negatively charged ion, and the other ions will move fast. Got it? This is known as ion exchange chromatography. And affinity chromatography, these columns are packed with specific material or specific ligands. These are packed with specific ligands or substrate in case of enzymes. If you want to separate enzymes, it is packed with a substrate, which enzyme has specificity towards a substrate, or antigen antibody. Specific antigen, and they are packed with specific antigen or antibody, and they are used for separation of specific antigen and antibody. This is known as affinity chromatography. So these are the five basic physicochemical principles involved in a separation in chromatography. So two terminologies should be clear, means two things should be clear in your mind. The first one is which the procedure which we are doing follows which principle. First, which principle? Adsorption, partition, molecular sieving, ion exchange, or affinity. And it is which type of chromatography, means what is stationary phase and what is mobile phase. And what is definition here? Chromatography, separation technique. It is a procedure or a technique in which separation of a similar compound occur based on their continuous redistribution between two phases, stationary phase and mobile phase. Got it? Now, after this, we will see the applications of this chromatography. It has a lot of application, and this method, specifically HPLC and HPTLC, these are the important methods for determination or measuring the concentration of analytes. Okay, for measurement of analytes such as drugs, hormones, vitamins, enzyme, etc., they are used. It is a gold standard method. HPLC is a gold standard method for analytical process, analysis of analytes. Okay, so uses or applications of chromatography. The first, paper chromatography. See, the paper chromatography, it is used for separation of amino acids, reducing sugar. Thin layer chromatography, paper chromatography, it is used for separation of amino acids, reducing sugars. Then they are used for purification of carbohydrate, proteins, lipids, nucleic acid, etc., enzymes, vitamins, drugs. Then third, HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography. It is a gold standard method for measurement of analytes. It is used for measurement of drugs, concentration of drugs, vitamins, hormones, enzymes, okay, amines, etc. It is a primary reference method for measurement of analytes. Okay, main use is separation, then purification, then it is used for measurement of various analytes. It is used for screening of inborn error of metabolism. Screening of inborn errors of metabolism. Okay, these are some uses of chromatography.